Hello everybody, welcome to my little aquaponic greenhouse. This is JT Bear. I just thought I would show you all really quickly what's going on here early November in my aquaponic system. I, as always, have decided to keep it running 24/7, 12 months a year, which is kind of foolish since this isn't Canada, but I have sprouts, look. So out of those seeds that I sprinkled in here, I do have quite a few sprouts that are coming up. There, that's a better angle. And I'm even starting to get my first true leaves on them. So that's excellent. I have tried growing clones from kale in the past in the fall, but didn't work out well for me, so hopefully these seedlings will do just fine. As you can see, the strawberry plant there is doing all right. Maybe a slight sign of deficiency there, but waiting is. That one kale seems to be doing just fine, looking about time for a salad, really. Green onions. Like 10 months ago, bought those at the store, cut them to the whites, stuffed them in the aquaponics. This is great. I love how well green onions do in aquaponics. I do have this issue, though. I mean, they tend to get to a height, and then they just kind of flop over. There's another one you can see off to the side that's done the same thing. The lavender's coming back. It's tricolor sage. Now, I believe I've mentioned before that I enjoy watching this go through the seasons because of the different colors it gets. But there are some good examples of the purples. I really enjoy that. Colorful food. Do love the colorful food. Alright, so before my camera dies here, we're going to take a really quick look at the fish, see how they're doing, see how that settlement filter is doing, and then we'll take a look over at the No Power Aquaponic Garden. It's getting a little bit cooler, but these guys still seem to enjoy the occasional feed. And as you can see, that water is just fantastic. I still have to drop the waterproof camera in there, but I'd like to find a way to maybe light the tank when I do that so we can really get a good look at the coloring on those fish. The new ones seem to be settling in just fine. The place where I use the liquid rubber to connect that and fill my slightly too large gap has held really, really well. I'm very impressed with that. So we're hiding in my shadow here, but I don't know if you can tell just how much muck is accumulating on the edges and along the cord to that little 50 watt heater that I've got going in there. But all of the solids seems to be pretty much dropping straight down into that one point. And that there along the bottom is a piece of half inch PVC pipe that I dropped in there as kind of a measuring stick so I could see how much filth was building up in there. That does seem to be working. That's crazy. Gonna be time to clean that out soon, I think. Well, here you see my two goldfish in my No Power aquaponic system. A little camera shy, but doing pretty good. Considering there's no pump, there's no, you know, standard filter, there's no airstone, there's no heater, there's just a Rubbermaid tote, some rocks, and a couple of goldfish. The plants themselves seem to be doing just fine. Even that pepper plant is doing surprisingly well. It gets really cold in here at night, so a lot of the leaves are changing color and dropping. But again, or should I say still, it's doing the best it can to put out new growth at the base. So I think it's just going to stay out here and see how long it can make it. This mint here, this was the waterfall solids filter, but I'm going to be moving this into that waterfall garden for now until I can get some stevia going. This mint is doing fantastic. This mint looks lovely. I really do like the way it just kind of hangs down there and just gets so bushy off of there. I think it's time to come in here and make some tea. There's my wisteria. Really doing quite well, all things considered. Willow cuttings, strawberries. The strawberries seem to love the no-power aquaponic thing. You know, again, some yellowing due to temperature in here. But considering what the strawberries outside the greenhouse look like, these look fantastic. I do want to make a strawberry bin, though. Probably going to put them where these three Folgers cans are. I'll put a Rubbermaid tote in here. Well, I'll just show you that when I do it. So there you are. I'll look around the aquaponics and the fish tanks and such here in my little greenhouse early in November. I am going to try and keep it going. I will keep you all updated as things develop. And you know what? Maybe tomorrow I'll make that little grow bed for the no power aquaponic garden. And I'll be sure to bring you along after I charge up the camera. So thanks for watching, everybody. Have yourselves a fantastic day. Feel free to comment down below if this has inspired any thoughts or if you see anything I'm totally screwing up, because that's always a possibility. Until next time, have yourselves a wonderful day.